Hi. Well, let's just start out by saying my name is Sheila, and this is a longtime friend of mine, Roger Leatt, the inventor of the Kimberly Stove.
Hello.
Hi. So I have a lot of questions for you. I've had many people ask a lot of questions about the Kimberly and how it came to be. So what better venue than YouTube to give the answers to all those questions?
Perfect.
So first of all, so Roger, how was Kimberly born?
Out of necessity. We were freezing to death on our boat, and we tried high and low to find good heating sources on our boat. We tried propane, we tried kerosene, we tried electric generators. We nearly gassed ourselves with carbon monoxide. We almost got kicked out of the marina, all the noise.
Wow.
Expensive and wet. Wow. Propane carries water, about 35% water. All that condensation ended up in the boat. So we had moldy pillows, we had moldy blankets, we had moldy everything. It was a horrible way to live. With my 27 years in the industry of wood stoves, I decided to try to build something for ourselves. I had no idea any of you would be watching this today. 4 years later, she's selling internationally, and
okay.
I guess that was God's idea of giving me a project to do.
Well, there you go. And what better one at that?
Amen.
So, if it came from a boat, it must be pretty small, obviously. How big is this, or
25 and a half inches tall, 10-inch diameter. It weighs 56 pounds.
Wow.
We are through with our, well, we're going to probably get into that later. We're through with all our testing and everything, and we have some of the tightest installation clearances in the industry because of its manufacturing process.
Okay. Wow. Being that small, does it make the Kimberly portable?
Oh, yes. 56 pounds.
Wow.
If you want to take it from your boat to your house to your cabin to your RV, just hook up a chimney in those places and you can carry the stove place to place.
I've never even heard of that.
No, neither have I.
That's amazing. That's awesome. So what are the specs, the emissions, the BTU, etc.?
Let's start off with the emission portion because that's what everybody wants to know about today.
Yeah.
Emissions. What are you talking about emissions? When you see smoke pouring out of a chimney, that's wasted fuel.
Okay.
It's also carcinogenic in nature, so all that smoke is bound to cause somebody cancer. In the old days of wood stoves, 60 to 70 grams an hour, in other words, like a 1 pound coffee tin, was going up into the air.
Wow.
Today we are reburning the gases produced from the primary fire in the secondary part of the stove. We are down to 3.2 grams an hour.
Woo!
The national limit right now is 7.5 grams an hour.
That's amazing.
In 2014, it comes down to 4.5, and we're still way ahead of that.
That's awesome, Roger.
40,000 BTU output on its top end means that you can heat up to 1,500 square feet of well-insulated living area with this little unit.
This little unit.
This little guy.
Oh my gosh. I want me one. How were you able to get such low emissions for such a small unit?
Well, as I said, we basically have two different burn zones within the fire.
Uh-huh.
The bottom is what we consider a gasifier. Mm-hmm. We're not really aggressively burning the fuel, we're turning it into gases. So we do that around 500 or 600 degrees. By the time all those gases rise up to the top and they're mixed with more fresh air, we get a secondary fire up in this area, which will hit around 1760 degrees.
Ooh.
On its top run. Complete wood combustion occurs at 1100. In other words, there is nothing left at the end of the burn.
Wow. Okay, so how does this gasifier work?
Well, like I said, you've got a smoldering fire down here.
Okay.
It's not an aggressive fire, so it's going to give off a lot of smoke.
Okay.
All we've got to do is reignite that smoke with a fresh charge of oxygen on the top end. So when you look, when this thing's running on low, this way, you might have a very small flame on the bottom, and you can see all the gassy smoke going up to the top. And if you look up into the door, you'll see what looks like the sunshine burning up there, because it is just absolutely inferno in the
top.
That's
amazing. So that's what's heating it all up here?
Yep.
Making all the heat go out?
70% of the heat created for the stove is on the top end, not the bottom.
Okay. All right. We're good. Well, I guess you kind of answered this already. So with a second combustion, how hot can it get?
Up to 1700 in the core, which gives you about a 1250 degree cooktop temperature.
Cooktop, so awesome. Okay, that goes with my next, I think. How long does one load of fuel last, and for how big of a space?
There's a thousand answers to that one.
Okay.
Basically, what I want to kind of relay to people is that if you've got a well-insulated 1,500 square foot home, mm-hmm. one Presto log mm-hmm. in here will burn you all night long and keep your house plenty warm.
What, like 8 hours, 10
yeah,
hours?
Yeah, 8 okay. hours at least wow. is what we tell people.
We've 8 gotten, hours off of one log.
We've gotten up to 12. Crazy. I don't advertise that. I'd rather tell people 8 and they get 12 and they're surprised.
Yeah.
But yeah, typically 8 hours is a full load of fuel.
That's great. Oh, and for how big of a space?
Up to 1,500.
Okay. What kind of wood does it use and what works best?
The best in my mind is a Presto log.
Okay.
There's a company called Home Fire Presto Logs out of Surrey, Canada. Mm-hmm. They make a log which is completely recycled sawdust material. Mm-hmm. There's no binders, waxes, glues, chemicals, any of that stuff. Okay. They're an extruded log. So we're using garbage to make heat, and I like that.
Yeah, definitely. Where can you get one of those? I mean, where is it?
Oh, most of the stove shops and big chain stores carry that product.
Okay. What's something like that cost? Like a dollar?
A buck a log.
Dollar
a log.
Nice.
The other part is that people can use Madrona, any hardwood.
Okay.
Good hardwood. You can burn anything.
You can put anything in it. So yeah. You could put, like, let's say something crazy. How about driftwood from the beach?
Definitely.
Really?
Our warranty covers
no
driftwood
way.
Because it's stainless steel.
Nice.
I don't think you'll hear another manufacturer tell you that one.
Very good. How long do you have to clean out the small ash pan?
Oh, how often?
Mm-hmm.
It takes almost 3 weeks to fill that up.
Woo! Wow. On the Presto log?
On the Presto log. If you're going to burn wet alder, you're going to dump it every few days.
Okay.
But if you're burning good wood, which you should be, it can take up to 3 weeks to fill that up.
Wow, that's great. And that's burning 24/7, you
mm-hmm.
say? Wow. Okay. Does it have any other accessories? And if so, what do they do?
They do. It does. It's coming. The top of our stove can be removed, and a different top can go on it, which will have a set of stainless steel water coils that are immersed in that 1,700 degree range, so we can produce a lot of hot water very quickly.
Wow.
We've got an oven, which I should have brought. So I could show
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah.
But it just sits down on the top, twist locks into place. You got a door, it opens up. You can cook a small chicken in there. We've been making
cookies.
Yeah, you know about that.
Yeah.
So we're really trying to get people more and more off-grid.
Nice.
Another addition that's coming out real quick, we have two thermoelectric generators. They're all attached to the back of the stove. One has a water cooling loop, so it's a little bit more advanced. It costs a little bit more, but it makes a lot more power. The more simple plug-and-play device, actually you can set it on top, and once it reaches about 550 degrees, it starts putting out 12-volt power.
That answered my next question. It's
yeah.
like, how much power will the heat generate? So
on the smaller unit, it's 2.7 amps, an adjustable 12 to 14 volts at 35 watts.
Wow.
So you can charge your battery banks with it, just like you do a solar panel system.
Right.
In fact,
right.
if you've got solar panels...
So you can convert back and forth.
Right.
Nice.
If you've got solar panels, you're probably going to have a smart charger.
Uh-huh.
So during the day, your panels will charge the charger for you.
Okay.
And at night, this will produce the same power as the solar panels do.
Oh, my goodness.
Easy addition.
Oh, my goodness. That's awesome. Makes me want to live off-grid.
We may have to. It's probably coming.
Yeah. Do you have any future accessories for Kimberly?
The one that we haven't really talked about yet, it's still in design, is a wall cabinet system. Generally, that's going to be aimed at the serious off-gridder, the tiny house type people. The vision is to have a non-flammable wall cabinet system built with big enough alcove to put the stove fully into.
Safely.
Right. And
yeah.
then you can have your oven on top. You can still have a teapot on it. Above that alcove will be a set of cabinet doors with louvered shelves,
uh-huh.
so the heat from the stove can rise up through those louvered shelves,
wow.
dry out your firewood, dehydrate foodstuffs, and then off to the side, we can have two more sets of cabinets where heat will dry your wet laundry.
And still heat your house
and
all the
same.
Still
heat your house, right. So now we can heat, cook, bake, produce electricity, produce hot water, dry your laundry, your firewood, and your fuel.
All for this.
I'll do that.
This little guy. Also, I forgot to mention, I didn't have it in one of my questions, but it was your footprint.
Oh, 22 inches in width, 34 inches in depth. If you've got that much floor space to give up, you're safe to put Kimberly in there.
Nice.
That'll also give you a 16-inch parts in front of the loading door.
Okay.
Now, there's a lot of applications for this guy. We have done, like I mentioned, the UL list. We did the EPA certification, and we did CSA requirement for Canadian export. When it comes to houses, we can install this 6 inches from a flammable wall with absolutely no wall protection at all.
Really?
Seriously.
EPA approved?
UL tested.
UL tested.
Right. Now, when it comes to boats, motorhomes, most yurts, things like that, there's really no jurisdiction on a lot of that. So we tell people, stay at the 6 inches.
Yeah.
Install safe. I don't want anybody, you know, doing something stupid right. and burning their house down. Because, let's face it, it's a wood stove. Any wood stove has...
And it's a powerful one at that.
Yeah. Any wood stove has its risk factors. But we do a lot of educating. Our buyers know what they're getting into. They know
right.
what's required of them to make it safe.
Right.
So, and with 27 years of never having anybody have a house fire...
Yay.
Please God, let's keep it up, man. Keep our people safe.
Yeah, totally. Okay, so are you looking for distributors? Or what would you call them?
Independent.
Dealers.
We're still looking at it. A lot of people have been signing up. Certain states are closed. Washington's already closed. Oregon is close to that. Colorado's close to that. Alaska's closed. California's, the north end is probably taken up.
So you got a lot of states available to
right.
but just the Northwest area and Canada
yeah, well
and Alaska is getting eaten up. Well, good to know. Okay, so lastly, what is your company's philosophy? What is the sole purpose of Kimberly's life?
The woman who gave me the inspiration to create Kimberly came to us when we were living on a boat after losing our store. And everything else that we owned. We were living on this little boat. And she said, I'd like you to read this article from the New Yorker magazine about the third world and how you could help them. And I said, do you see what I'm living in here? This is all I've got. What are you thinking? How am I going to help anybody? And she said, I think you've got the know-how to do what these people need. So I read the article. It was about children dying young of cancer, emphysema, or getting burned from indoor campfires that these ladies in the third world were cooking on. So the children were inhaling all this smoke.
That's wonderful.
They also were using magnesium car wheels. And when one of those things catches fire, shrapnel goes everywhere. I mean, it's a horrible thing. So after reading the article, I recognized that what they needed was what I needed on my boat to keep my family warm.
Right.
And so it was kind of a focal point to develop something.
It was the passion that drove you.
Yeah, right. And we named it Kimberly because that woman's name is Kimberly.
Oh, wow.
Now, we can't exactly subsidize this for the third world. It's too expensive. But we are working with a company called Trees Water People out of Denver.
Oh, wow.
Since 1995, they've been sending little itty-bitty efficient cook stoves to the third world.
Aww.
They're advertising our product, and for every one we sell through their promotion, we help them fund 5 stoves to the third world.
Oh my goodness, that's so awesome.
I think
that is so great.
It's a realization of the dream kind of in a different way.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, if the job's getting done, it also, Kimberly will help slow down deforestation. Kimberly will help stop pollution. Kimberly will provide cleaner air, cleaner water, and cleaner land for anybody that's using it. And that's really where she needs to go, what she needs to do. And let's face it, things are uncertain these days. I mean, there's so many reasons the grid could go down tomorrow. Anybody that's got one of these is going to be far, far ahead of the game when that kind of stuff happens.
Right. Wow. So, in closing.
It won't let you down.
Should we mention hi?
Yeah, we might as well go ahead. Any wood stove package is going to run around $4,000. By the time you do your stove, your floor pad, your chimney, labor to put it in, all the good stuff that goes with it. Kimberly's $3,500 shipped.
Okay.
The chimney system is very inexpensive. Mm-hmm. We did one last Friday. Mm-hmm. It took us exactly 2 hours from the time we showed up on site to the time we lit that thing up. And the lady was just shocked at how fast and easy it was.
That's amazing.
Anybody can do this. And we also can help people via internet. Uh-huh. They can send us pictures and measurements of where they want to put it in. We can tell them where to get the materials and how to do it step by step.
That's great.
Anyone can put one of these things in.
That's great.
Easy cheesy?
Yeah, easy cheesy. All right, Rod.
Thank you, my dear.
Thanks so much.
You bet.
Bye-bye.